Bizzibox's expert information on buying and storing chocolate. What should I look for on a chocolate label?
If you're looking at a chocolate bar label, the only things you want to see if it's a dark chocolate are cocoa solids, vanilla, sugar, and possibly soy lecithin. If it's milk chocolate, then milk's okay in that list as well.
What are your top tips when buying chocolate?
My top tips for buying chocolate are to read the label, so read the ingredients and see that it only has just the pure ingredients of chocolate. So again, cocoa butter, or cocoa solids, vanilla, sugar, and soy lecithin. And also that, you know, you need to get to know names. So I think it's worth going to a chocolate tasting or on a chocolate tour and learning about what brands you like. So everyone has their own preferences. And generally, the more you pay, the better quality chocolate it will be. But I mean, there are a lot of nicely packaged chocolate that isn't actually that good or not to your preference. So yeah, the best tip is to check the ingredients and just go out and explore.
How should I taste chocolate?
When you're tasting chocolate, you need to do it with all of your senses. So the first thing you want to do to tell whether you're having a good quality chocolate, or just to enjoy any good quality chocolate, is to look at the surface of it, and it should be shiny, and it shouldn't have any white spots on it, and it should also be a shade of brown. If you've got a black chocolate, then it likely means that the beans that have been used to make it were burnt, and you probably smell that as well. So once you've got shiny chocolate, chocolate melts at room temperature because it's only made with cocoa butter. Sorry, not room temperature, body temperature. It only melts at your body temperature, so you can rub it on your skin and it will melt into your skin and it won't leave a fatty residue, which cheaper quality chocolate would. And good quality chocolate should make a snap when you break it, a snapping sound. So just like that. And it should snap cleanly and evenly. That means it's been well tempered. And next thing you want to do is smell the chocolate. Now, a little bit like when you're tasting wine, you will smell a variety of notes. It might smell fruity, you might smell oak, you might smell tobacco. What you don't want to smell is burnt, anything that smells burnt, and you don't want to smell anything just too sweet, like sugar, or it shouldn't smell or taste metallic. Do want to be able to smell chocolate. Very important. So as long as you can smell chocolate, if you can't pick up any other notes, that's fine. Then finally, the best bit, obviously, you get to taste the chocolate. The best way to taste the chocolate is to break off either a small piece or a large piece. And if you put it on the middle of your tongue and push it to the roof of your mouth, that will help it to spread and melt evenly across all of your taste buds. And if you breathe in at the same time, then you'll also really get all of the aromas and flavors. And the best way to know whether chocolate is a really good chocolate is whether the flavor lingers after it's gone in your mouth. So it should last for at least 10 minutes afterwards. Where a cheaper quality chocolate, you'll want to go back straight away because it leaves a horrible taste. So yeah, now I'm gonna eat it.
Where can I buy really good chocolate?
You can buy really good chocolate in a lot of the chocolatiers in London and in most big cities and smaller cities too, I imagine. In terms of quality chocolate bars, good quality department stores sell them. So in London, you can buy really good chocolate in Harrods, Fortnum & Mason's, Liberty, Selfridges. And then you can get some good quality chocolate in Waitrose as well.
What should I expect to pay for quality chocolate?
Good quality chocolate will cost at least £2 per 100 grams, at least. The most expensive bar on sale in London is £9 for 50 grams. So, and that's the award-winning bar, and it's very good. The bars that I buy on a regular basis are about £3 to £4 for 100 grams.
How should chocolate be stored?
very important to store chocolate correctly. And the most important thing is to store it in an airtight container, because chocolate absorbs the other smells from the fridge or from the cupboard where you've got it. Ideally, it shouldn't be stored in the fridge. It should be stored between 12 and 20 degrees Celsius. If it's a lot hotter than that, then you can store it in the fridge, but you need to make sure that you keep it in the container and you let it come to room temperature before you open the container, or else you'll affect the flavour.
www.bizzybox.com